I'd like to thank the Scientific Committee of the conference for giving me this opportunity and being here with you. Our topic today is about anti-inflammatory diet in rheumatic diseases. Rheumatic diseases or musculoskeletal diseases are a group of diseases characterized by pain, reduction in range of motion, functional affection in one or more areas of musculoskeletal system. Some of rheumatic diseases show signs of joint inflammation like pain, swelling, redness, hotness, tenderness, as well as internal organ affection. Development of rheumatic diseases is based on both genetic and environmental factors. Dysbiosis of gut microbiota in which beneficial bacteria are lost and potentially pathogenic microbes increase is responsible for pathogenesis as well as the disease progression in some rheumatic diseases. Traditional treatment of rheumatic diseases involves taking medication like painkillers, anti-inflammatory medications, medications that suppress immune system. Adjunctive treatment include diet therapy using diet that reduce inflammation in what's called anti-inflammatory diet. The Mediterranean diet. It's archetype of an anti-inflammatory diet. Its anti-inflammatory effect can be measured by serum inflammatory markers and measures of endothelial function. Adherence to Mediterranean diet can reduce progression of chronic disease. Mediterranean diet is rich in vegetables, fruits, whole grains, fats in the form of nuts and olive oil, proteins in the form of legumes, lean poultry, and fish rather than red meat. Components of Mediterranean diet. Number one, fats. Form about 40% to 50% of daily caloric intake in the form of fresh, natural, organic, unrefined oils and fats. Butter or similar spreadable fats are discouraged. Omega-3 and omega-6 are essential fatty acids need to obtain from the diet that as they can't be synthesized by the body. In general, omega-6 fats lead to more inflammation and omega-3 metabolism lead to formation of anti-inflammatory prostaglandins and leukotrienes. The best source of omega-3 found in cold water fish such as salmon, mackerel, anchovies, sardines, herrings, in addition to olive oil, nuts, virgin coconut oil. Why omega-3? Omega-3 fats largely contain alpha-linolenic acid, rather than eicosapentaenoic acid and docosahexaenoic acid. The body needs to metabolize this ALA to eicosapentaenoic and docosahexaenoic to exert its anti-inflammatory effect. In plant-based forms of omega-3, about 10% to 15% of ALA is metabolized into eicosapentaenoic, then subsequently into docosahexaenoic. On the other hand, animal-based forms of omega-3, which is found in cold water fatty fish, naturally contain higher amounts of already performed eicosapentaenoic and docosahexaenoic, which exert anti-inflammatory effect without need to further metabolism. We should know fish oil supplements do not seem to yield the same omega-3 benefits as eating fish itself. Dietary sources of fat. Omega-3 fatty acids found in salmons, herrings, sardines, walnuts, as we mentioned before. Omega-6 fatty acids found in vegetable oils like corn, sunflower, sesame, soybeans. Found in some seeds like sunflower seeds, pumpkin seeds, sesame seeds. Also found in roasted soybeans, soybean butter. Monounsaturated fatty acids found in vegetable oils like olive oil, peanut oil, nuts like almond, cashews, peanuts, pistachios, pecans, peanut butter and almond butter, and avocado. Carbohydrates form about 30% to 40% of daily caloric intake. At least we have to take 25 grams of fibers per day from total carbohydrates. Whole grains contain naturally occurring fibers, lignans, magnesium, zinc, B vitamins, vitamin E. Replacing refined carbs with whole grains in diet reduce inflammatory markers. High dietary fibers and whole grains intake is associated with decreased CRP and interleukin-6. Excessive consumption of highly processed carbohydrates like which contain white flours and white flour and refined sugars with high glycemic load, even if in a single meal, lead to immediate increase in CRP and inflammatory cytokines. Sources of carbohydrate, carbs that are whole grain, like barley, brown rice, bulgur, and whole wheat bread, pasta, crackers, oatmeal, and popcorn. Why whole grain? Whole grain is composed of bran, which is rich in phytochemicals and fibers, and germ portion, which is which contain carbohydrates. Refining wheat with removal of fibers lead to 200 to 300 fold loss in phytochemicals and increase in speed of sugar absorption, which in turn lead to increased glycemic index that leads to high level of TNF-alpha and interleukin 6. Whole grain intake is supporting more favorable gut microbiota composition that lower both gut and systemic inflammation. Vegetables and fruits. Vegetables can contain the highest concentration of vitamins, minerals, and other protective phytochemicals with low calories compared with other foods. High intake of vegetables and fruits greater than 5 servings per day with more than half as vegetables has a significant adverse effect with inflammatory markers such as CRP, interleukin 6, and adhesion factors. Sources of vegetables found in and fruits found in yellow, orange, and red veggies, besides dark leafy greens, excluding potatoes. Proteins. Plant-based proteins, legumes, are a healthy alternative animal source of protein. Legumes are high in protein as well as fiber, iron, folic acid, and B vitamins. Essential amino acids like methionine and tryptophan are deficient in most legumes, while they are found in sufficient amount in most of grains. Consumption of legumes is associated with reduction in inflammatory markers and improvement in endothelial function. Animal protein sources from fish and low-fat dairy are suitable for anti-inflammatory diet. 2 servings of fatty fish per week is recommended. Fish and seafood. Source of high quality protein and healthy fat. In spite of pro-inflammatory and impaired metabolic function due to contaminated water with heavy metals such as mercury, cadmium, lead, the health benefits of eating fish exceed potential risk. Sources of fish found in tilapia, anchovies, wild salmon, avoid sharp swordfish and king mackerel because of high content of methyl mercury. Others. Herbs like ginger, chili pepper, oregano, basil, thyme, rosemary are also possess anti-inflammatory properties. Turmeric, regular administration of curcumin have shown improvements in inflammatory markers and endothelial markers, endothelial function. Daily dose of 2 grams of curcumin given in conjugation with standard therapy is recommended. Cocoa and cocoa-rich products such as dark chocolate contain high quantities of flavonoids as well as fibers. Reduction in serum inflammatory markers and enhanced endothelial function are reported with consumption of 1 to 2 ounces of flavonoid-rich cocoa in the form of dark chocolate at least 70%. Traumatic conditions that may improve with an anti-inflammatory diet. Osteoarthritis. Adherence to Mediterranean diet will lead to anti-inflammatory properties in the form of modulation of arachidonic acid sequence, besides antioxidant properties in the form of reduced oxidative stress biomarkers, besides body weight maintenance, with a net result of improvement of quality of life and they improve osteoarthritis onset. We have two studies about osteoarthritis. One of them found turmeric extract to be as good as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and controlling symptoms of knee arthritis, osteoarthritis. And the other said, beneficial effect of Mediterranean diet against the chronic inflammation, metabolic complication, and chronic disease were found. Rheumatoid arthritis. Adherence to Mediterranean diet will lead to anti-inflammatory effect and weight control, microbiota homeostasis that lead to joint health or improve joint health. Disturbance of this pyramid will lead to pro-inflammatory effect, gut dysbiosis and obesity that lead to rheumatoid arthritis. Here we have a study say that several nutrients such as polyunsaturated fatty acids have anti-inflammatory and antioxidant properties, giving a protective role for rheumatoid arthritis development, while others such as red meat have a harmful effect. Mediterranean diet, vitamin D, probiotics could be possible future adjunctive therapy to standard rheumatoid arthritis treatment. Inflammatory bowel syndrome, inflammatory bowel disease. Patients with inflammatory bowel disease, like Crohn's disease, of both Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, follow Mediterranean diet for 6 months. Their body mass index, body tissue composition, liver function, serum level profile, clinical disease activity, inflammatory biomarkers are measured at the first day of study and at the end of 6 months, which is the period of study. Study concluded a significant reduction of all these parameters in both Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis after short-term dietary intervention based on adoption to Mediterranean diet associated with improvement in disease activity and inflammatory marker. Psoriatic arthritis. This study evidenced that psoriatic arthritic patients with high level of disease activity as measured by disease activity index for psoriatic arthritis correlated with low adherence to Mediterranean diet, suggesting potential benefit of anti-inflammatory properties of this dietary pattern. Systemic lupus erythematosus. A cross-sectional study was conducted on 280 patients, concluded a greater adherence to Mediterranean diet seems to exert a beneficial effect on disease activity and cardiovascular risk in SLE patients. Gout. Mediterranean diet exerts its beneficial effect mainly through the reduction of pro-inflammatory cytokines and the increased anti-inflammatory cytokines, as well as attenuation of oxidative stress. We have two studies saying that adherence to Mediterranean diet is associated with lower serum uric acid level in addition to lowering risk of hyperuricemia. Patient handout. والحقيقة ده سؤال بنتسأله كتير جدا في الشغل من البيشنت من البيشنتس اللي بنشوفهم يوميا اكل ايه ما اكلش ايه ايه يفيدني ايه يضرني والسلايد دي فيها الاجابه بالتفصيل نمبر 1 تشوز هيلثي فات ان احنا بنساعد المريض ان هو ينقي نوع الدهون المناسب ليه بمعنى ان احنا بنعمل احلال لكل انواع الدهون بزيت الزيتون اكسترا فيرجن اويل وسبق وقلنا ليه eat 2 servings of fatty fish per week reduce use of omega 6 fats to keep ratio of omega 3 to omega 6 in range of 2:1 or 4:1. Number 2, increase vegetable and fruit intake. 3, choose whole grain carbohydrates. Get protein from plant sources as legumes, nuts, seeds, or choose lean natural animal sources of protein in moderate amounts. Spice it up. Eat mindfully. مهم جدا المريض يكون واعي وفاهم هو بياكل ايه على حد سواء بالنسبة للكواليتي والكوانتيتي زي بعض. Focus on whole diet pattern, not just components. Choose food that is close to natural form. وعلى قد ما نقدر نبعد عن processed food. Eat food, not too much, mostly plants. دي قاعدة مهمة جدا، لو حطناها في بالنا هنقدر نجاوبه بسهولة. Follow an anti-inflammatory lifestyle in the form of regular exercise. Keep weight under control, reduce obesity, and healthy ways to reduce stress. رقم 10 وآخر حاجة، لو قدر إن هو يحاول إن هو ياخد 1 to 2 ounces of dark chocolate على الأقل التركيز 70% هيكون مفيد جدا ليه. طريقة تانية للإجابة على السؤال ده، إن أنت ممكن تاكل إيه أكتر، ممكن تاكل إيه أقل. Eat more food high in omega 3, vegetables, whole grains, anti-inflammatory spices. Eat less of food high in trans fat, saturated fat, food high in omega 6 fat, refined carbohydrates like white bread or bagels, English muffins, instant or white rice, rice in and corn cereal, crackers, cookies, cakes, sodas and juice. حتى لو كانت juice للدايت. This is our references and thank you.